So question number 5, if f bar is this one, then show that the curl f bar at these two points are orthogonal. So again, the question is very straightforward here. First of all, we should find a curl f bar vector, and then we have to prove that curl f bar at these two particular points is orthogonal. Orthogonal means they are perpendicular. Okay, so let me start first curl f bar there. Let me find out curl f bar vector. So curl f bar, we know it is a del cross f bar. So the first row of del cross f bar is always a unit vector ijk. Second row, the components of del operator, which are dou by dou x, dou by dou y, and dou by dou z. And the third row are f1, f2, f3. F1 is x square minus y square plus 2xz. So this one is f1. F2 is xz minus xy plus yz. And f3 is x square plus z square. So that about f3. So let me expand this determinant along the first row. Yes, what is the derivative of f3 with y?
0.
0. Minus derivative of f2 with a z. Observe, this is the derivative. Minus j cap. Derivative of f3 with x. Is that a 2x? Derivative of f1 with a z. So this is a 0. This is 0. And I will say this is again a minus 2x plus k into. Now let me take this differentiation. Derivative of f2 with x, this is a z minus y. And derivative of f1 with y, so that is a minus plus 2y. So we got a del cross f bar or curl f bar vector as minus x plus y of I cap, and if you observe, this is a y plus z plus y plus z k cap. That's one. This middle term, yes, this term gets cancelled here, and that is a 0 j. So j component will not be there. So we got a curl f bar vector. Now this is a general curl. So right now the vector field is a rotational field. It's a rotational. And now we have to prove this curl f bar at these two particular points, at these two particular points, is orthogonal, means perpendicular. How to prove they are orthogonal?
Dot product 0.
Yes, obviously a dot product. So dot product 0. We use dot product should be 0 there. Good. So we'll say let a bar is curl f bar at the first point, say 1, 2, minus 3. So the vector a bar will become, so if you replace 1, 2, minus 3, you will get minus 3i, and this is a 2 minus 3, this is a minus k cap. And let me say b bar is a vector which is a curl f bar at the another point, say 2, 3, 12, and this vector will we get as a minus 5i plus 10k. The last step is left here. Our aim is to prove these are orthogonal. Therefore, consider, I will write it here. Consider a bar dot b bar. If you take a bar dot b bar, say a1b1 plus a2b2, we get plus 15. As a dot b is a 0, simplifies a bar is orthogonal. A bar is orthogonal or perpendicular to b bar. And that's the required answer. If anyone have any doubt here, yes, you can ask. Yes, any doubt? Are you completed?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so let I move to the next question here. So this is another question where just we have to prove del dot r bar is a 0, del cross r, sorry, del dot r bar is 3, del cross r bar is a 0, del of r raised to n is n into r raised to n minus 2 into r bar with standard notation. Now what is a vector r bar? Generally it is not written. What is the standard vector r bar here?
Xi
plus yj plus z.
Yes, that is a position vector. So without giving the vector r bar, you should remember this is with the standard notation. Generally the r bar is always, this r bar vector is always this xi plus yj plus zk. So this is the vector r bar. It's a position vector. So proof of the first bit is very simple. We have to prove del dot r bar is a 0. So by definition, the first bit I will say del dot r bar. Okay. Del dot r bar is like dou f1 by dou x plus dou f2 by dou y plus dou f3 by dou z, where that r bar is equal to f bar, and that is xi plus yj plus zk. So dou x by dou x, the first value will come as 1 plus 1 and plus 1. So the answer is come 3. So that is one step proof. Okay, one step proof. The second is also a very obvious one. It is just by definition del cross r bar. Del cross r bar is a determinant whose first row is obviously that I, j, k. Second row, the operator del, which is a dou by dou x, dou by dou y, dou by dou z. And third row is the components of r bar, which are x, y, z. And now we have to find out this expansion of this determinant. We'll observe that I cap derivative of f3 with a z, so dou z by dou y is 0. Similarly, dou y by dou z is a 0. So this is a 0 minus 0 minus z. You will observe everywhere you will happen this one only, and we say that's a 0 bar, that's a 0 vector. Hence curl r bar, curl of r bar is a 0 vector, while the divergence of r bar is a 3. Divergence of r bar is 3, curl of r bar is a 0 vector. Any doubt in the first two part? It is a straightforward definition oriented. Just use a definition and do a calculation. Once you complete these two part, tell me. We'll move to the third part of this question.
Yes, sir. Completed.
Yes, sir. Completed.
Completed. So the third part, our aim is to prove del of r raised to n is n into r raised to n minus 2 into r bar. What is the value of r? What is the value of r?
Excuse me, sir.
Yes. What is the value of r here?
Sir, under root x square plus y square plus.
Yes, correct. Root of, that is the magnitude of vector r bar. Very good. So the first thing that we have.
Hello.
Yes. What is the problem, Deb?
Sir, I'm asking the question 4 times or 5 times. You are not listening.
You are not audible. How we can hear then?
Okay.
Yes.
Sir, in the previous question, what does the zero vector mean?
You are not audible still. Just I heard three words in the previous question. Zero vector. That's one only. Okay. Let I check on the chat then. If you put. So zero vector means what? Zero vector means it is a irrotational vector. We already seen that, no? When del cross r bar is a zero vector indicates the vector field is a irrotational There is no rotation component present in that vector field. That's one only. We already discussed that things in theory part. Okay. So last thing, the vector R bar is already, we know that R, just a minute. This R bar is xi plus yj plus zk. Therefore, R is equal to square root of x square plus y square plus z square. That's a magnitude of vector R bar. So r raised to n will come x square plus y square plus z square raised to n by 2. Okay, this is raised to n by 2. So that will be the value of r raised to n there. Now del of r raised to n is, now in this case it comes as like a gradient, because r raised to n is a scalar function. You'll observe r raised to n is a scalar function. Now del of r raised to n is equal to dou x of that r raised to n plus dou y of r raised to n plus dou z of r raised to n. So this is just by definition of a gradient. Okay, by definition of gradient. So give this is a, or just we want now these partial derivatives. If we we can write it directly also. If we want to differentiate this, yes, anyone tell me the derivative of this RHS or derivative of R, this R raised to n with respect to x, partial derivative.
N by 2.
Yes, very good.
X square.
Huh?
Raised to power n by 2 minus 1.
Very good. The bracket raised to n by 2 minus 1 into
2x.
Into 2x. Is anything I missed in the writing the definition of del of R?
I cap, J cap, K cap.
Very good. So this is the most important thing. If you forgot this thing, you will not get a marks there. So here is I cap, J cap, and K cap, because gradient is a vector quantity. So I should write here into I cap then. Now similarly, the other derivatives will go, because it's a symmetric function. It's a symmetric function. If you just calculate with x, you get with y and z, just replacing x to the y to the z and z to the x. So it is a similar partial derivatives, n by 2, x square plus y square plus z square, bracket raised to n by 2 minus 1 into 2y, j cap. And the lastly, n by 2, x square plus y square plus z square raised to n by 2 minus 1 into 2z, k cap. So one simple thing that we can observe that can be taken as a common, which is a n by 2. Now this bracket is nothing but it is a, you'll observe this is R square. This is R square. So I'll write R square raised to n by 2 minus 1. Okay, and we are left with, yes, well, that 2 is also coming common, or I will do one small simplification. So this 2, I will not write it here. Instead, I will say this 2 gets cancelled everywhere. This 2 gets cancelled here, this 2 gets cancelled here. Okay, that 2 gets cancelled everywhere. So n into, this is R square raised to n by 2 minus 1. That is one thing I done. And now, we left with here is like only xi plus yj plus zk. That's one. You'll observe, if you cross multiply, this become n minus 2 upon 2. So R square raised to n minus 2 upon 2. So square root and that square gets cancelled and we get n into R raised to n minus 2 into R bar. And that's the required answer. That's the proof. So these are just identities, just vector identities we can say. And that we are proving with a standard notation. Okay, whatever the three, these three are there. Rarely these will come. Hardly first two will come, that is coming for 2 marks. Okay, that will come only for 2 marks there. Thank you. Yes, are you completed?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
So, someone is on the chat. Okay, yes. Aman. Question number 7 here. So, a similar question, we already done this type. We have to find out the function phi which satisfy this gradient of a phi should be r bar upon r raised to 4. Just give me the starting step here. How to start this problem? We are given r bar upon r raised to 4 is some vector, and that our aim is to get a function phi whose gradient is gradient should come r bar upon r raised to 4. Yes, anyone?
Sir, first we should find phi by integrating. Okay.
Yes, by integrating.
And then after that, we'll get a C out there. So we'll put 1 and 0, we'll get C, and then we'll put it, we'll get phi of R.
Okay, good, good. So the way we should start, there are definitely the way that where we completed previously also. I think we should start with, as we want function phi. So first of all, given del phi is equal to r bar upon r raised to 4. R bar is actually xi plus yj plus zk divided by r raised to 4, means it is x square plus y square plus z square bracket square. Is that? Now, therefore, the function phi, we can use that formula that we seen in the previous case also there, that phi is integration of f1 dx. Yes, Akshat. Integration of f2, the formula says, so you can go shortcut method or that other method also, terms free from x of f2 dy, treating z as a constant, plus integration terms free from xy of f3 dz. That's one. That is just a formula. Now let me replace integration. What is f1? Yes. What's f1 here? X upon x square plus y square plus z square bracket square. Okay, this is x upon, y upon, and z upon. That will be there. So this will be the f1 dx, treating y and z as a constant. Yes, is there any term free from x of f2? How many terms are in f2? How many terms are there in f2? So if
one.
F2 is only f1. One term, y upon x square plus y square bracket square, and that is not free from x. So it's a 0 dy. Similarly, there is only one term in F3, that is z upon this bracket square, and that is not free from x and y, so that is a 0 dz. Okay, so this is a 0 dy, 0 dz, nothing is a free there, plus the constant of integration. Yes, you can start from the beginning also if you want. So this one, plus c is there. Okay, that constant of integration I missed there. Now, how to integrate this? How to integrate?
By using u by v rule.
Not correct. U by v rule is not for integration. That is for derivative there. Okay. The quotient rule is only in the differentiation, not for integration there. It is, we are integrating with x. Y and z are like a constant.
Sir, we can put it this as t.
Yes, it is by substitution method. No need to put it as a t because we already know this x square plus y square plus z square is r square. Okay, so you can convert it into the r form only. So I will say here,
excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Yes. Sir, after dz, what is written there?
0 dz plus c, the constant of integration.
How many terms are there? 3 and 4.
Yes, first term is with f1, then f2, and third is plus c, the constant of integration there.
Okay, sir.
These are zeros at all. These middle terms, no need to write at actually. This is just for your... Let x square plus y square plus z square is r square. That is already there. It is not necessary to write let also. As x square plus y square plus z square is r square, we say 2x dx is equal to 2r dr. So this x dx becomes r dr. So the function phi will become like this. Integration of x dx, I will write it as r dr divided by, now this is the r square, so it become r raised to 4. Is it r raised to 4? Yeah. X square plus y square plus z square is r square. So that is r raised to 4. So you will observe this we get here plus constant of integration. I missed again. Plus c. So this is integration of 1 upon r cube. What is integration of 1 upon r cube?
Minus 3 upon r raised to the power 4.
Minus, not correct. Is that?
Minus 1 by 2 r square.
Yeah. Yes, minus 1 by 2 r square is the correct answer. How you can confuse with the derivative and integration? This is already r cube is there. Plus c. So phi become minus 1 by 2 r square plus c, because it's r raised to minus 3 integration. Is a minus 3 plus 1 upon minus 3 plus 1. So minus 1 by 2 r square is integration plus c. So this is the general solution we got. This is one step we got. This is the general solution we got. Minus 1 by 2 r square plus c. We use this condition phi of 1 equal to 0. Phi of 1 equal to 0. And using this condition, yes, we can get the value of this constant of integration plus c. Okay. How to get now? So just put... this is a function of r. We got function of r. Phi of r is minus 1 by r square plus c. So just replace r by 1. This whatever the value of 1 mini, it is a function of single variable, and that variable is in this case r. So let me replace r by 1 and we get a c equal to. Okay. So I will write it somewhere this side. But, or I will erase little part here, this part. But, phi of 1 is equal to 0 implies that we replace 0 is equal to, this phi of 1 is 0, minus 1 by 2 plus c. So we got c equal to 1 by 2. Thus, phi becomes 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2 r square. And that is the end of the question. If any doubt is here, yes, you can ask. So this question is exactly similar question where we find, we observe that four questions already show that f bar is irrotational, hence find the scalar function phi such that f bar is equal to del phi. So in this case only, we have to find out the function phi such that this f bar is equal to del phi. So this is our f bar here. That's only the difference there. So it is just like a second part of that question only. So we use that shortcut formula, or there is another way also to do this problem. And that problem, that way is you have to just integrate with x, y, and z and find the constant of integration. That's another method. We already discussed that. So, but the simple method is this one only. Any doubt here?
No, sir.
So can we move to the next question then?
Yes, sir. Okay.
Yes, sir. Good.
So this is one of the simple questions. So simple. The vector f bar is given and we have to prove it is a both solenoid and irrotational. Can you tell me what we have to do it here?
Yes, sir. We have to find that delta into a vector equals to 0.
Huh?
And same for the solenoid.
first we have to prove here del dot f bar is a zero, that is a solenoid. And next we have to prove del cross f bar is a zero, and that is a irrotational. Okay. So I think this question, all you can do it, but okay, let me do it quickly. It's not so difficult. So the first one, del dot f bar. Del dot f bar is dou f1 by dou x plus dou f2 by dou y plus dou f3 by dou z. Now let me write dou f1 by dou x, derivative of f1 with x is yes, obviously 0, 0 and 0, and that's a del dot f bar is a 0. And we say this implies f bar is solenoid. This question will come for 2 mark only. Okay, don't think it is a 5 mark question. Now del cross f bar equal to del cross f bar is equal to, it's a determinant, first row ijk, next row the operator dou by dou x, dou by dou y, dou by dou z, and the last row f1, f2, f3, which is yz, xz, xy. And let me check what happens with the partial derivative, derivative of f3 with y, that is x. So we get these vectors then. With x it is a, and the partial derivatives will go like this, and we get it as a 0 bar. Hence f bar is irrotational. If any doubt, yes, you can ask. One of the simple question, 2 mark question only. And if you complete it, tell me. We'll move to the next question then.
Yes, sir, done.
Yeah, I know this is one of the simple question, and you can do it your own also, if not written. Probably last or second last question. So if A bar and B bar are irrotational, we have to prove A cross B is a solenoid vector. Yes, anyone? How to start here? How to prove A cross B as a solenoid? So I'll write it here. Given del cross A bar 0, del cross B bar 0. Consider, we have to prove A cross B vector as a solenoid. So we have to prove del dot of A cross B should be 0. That we have to prove it as a 0. Yes, anyone? Can you guess? It is very simple. It's one step. Yeah.
First of all, we have to find A cross B.
D cross D means?
A cross B.
But A and B are not given. No? It's a general vector given. How you can find A cross B vector?
It's a scalar triple product.
Yes, it's a very good. It's a scalar triple product. So how to get the value of a scalar triple product? A dot. So del dot.
Determinant.
Is it determinant? But
yes.
But again, that problem is there. If we write in the determinant, first operator is dou dou x, and we get A bar and B bar. But A bar and B bar are not available. That's not given. It's a, one of the simple thing.
You know, sir, we can rearrange it like B dot del cross A, and del cross A 0.
Dot yes, B sir. Bar.
Yes, sir.
Scalar triple product and can be written this way.
Yes, sir. But sir, and del cross A 0.
0 vector, this is a by given, dot B bar. So dot product of 0 vector with any vector is a 0. That's one.
Yes,
sir. Hence, A cross B is a 0 vector. That's just a property. Actually, what we've done, A dot B cross C is equal to A cross B dot C. That property we used, and we say A cross B is a solenoid. No determinant, or A cross B, obviously we cannot compute because A and B are general vector. Okay, so it's in 2018, I think it is asked for 2 marks again. Rarely these questions are coming this type, but yeah, majority times you have the numericals only. These proofs or the properties are rarely coming here, but they are not difficult. Always you first focus on what is given, write that. Then what we have to prove, focus on the other thing, how you can proceed. Okay, whether by formula, definition, or the property. Okay, then last question is left here. So let I move to the last question here. Last question of vector differentiation. The question number 14. If u into f bar is equal to del v, where u and v are scalar function. Okay, they are scalar function. F bar is a vector function. Show that f bar into curl f bar is a 0. F bar into curl f bar is a 0. Now tell me how to prove this. This is a 5-mark question.
First take u that side, like f bar is equal to del v by u.
Del v by u, not correct.
Remember, 1 by u into del
v. 1 by u into del v, that is okay. Okay. So,
then we'll apply the property of
so
curl.
We can start like this. Given u into f bar is equal to del v. So this gives us f bar is 1 by u of del v. So you cannot take del of v upon u. Okay, that is a different thing. So this is okay. Now consider or del cross f bar, we can find it first. Or we can start whatever we want. So consider f bar. Now del cross f bar is a vector. So here is again del cross f bar. Curl f bar means del cross f bar. So f bar dot curl f bar. So we can say one by u del v dot del cross yes, can we do something now?
So it's a scalar triple product, so the terms are repeating, shall be zero.
Terms are repeating it, yeah. Okay, so first, there is no need. So curl f bar is a vector, f bar is also a vector. Why the question is asked, I don't know then. Because whatever f bar, whatever the vector f bar there, it will be always zero because f bar dot del cross f bar is always zero there.
For 7 marks, we'll write only 2 lines.
So no, that time it is of 7 marks. Now definitely the questions are coming maximum for 5 mark here. Yes, we can go in the detail. Like first you can write del v. Del v is like dou v1 by dou xi plus dou v2 by dou yj plus dou v3 by dou z. Okay, and then 1 by u, you can multiply there. And then you can go that way. But if you observe here, as a vector f bar is repeating in a triple, this one.
Sir, like, can we apply the property like curl of fg is equals to gradient of g into f plus g into curl of f, that property?
Tell me what is the property you want to say?
So like curl of fg, where g is the vector part.
Okay, both f and g are vector.
No sir, f is not. So like 1 by u is
okay,
not.
Okay.
So
fg bar. Like that.
So like that will be equal to gradient of f cross g.
Okay, so the first into the derivative of second that way.
Yes, sir. Plus f into curl of g.
Dot g bar plus f into del cross g bar. Is that?
Yes, sir. And then if we put like this, no, then also it'll come, but it'll be longer.
No, that is okay, but we have to check whether this property is there. Yes, the properties, del properties are there, like it follows a quotient rule, product rule, that's okay. But you have to check it for a scalar and vector together. If it is both scalar, na, if curl of f into g, del of f into g, then you can apply product rule, that is okay. But this property, you have to confirm whether it is a correct or not. Then only use it. Okay. But right now, this is a very trivial question that was asked. Actually, you can write then that way also. No need to go this way. Nothing is required. So, we already know A dot B cross C. This is just like a box. It is a scalar triple product, no? This is like a box product. The box product of F bar, del, and again F bar. We can say that is equal to 0 because you can say as 2 vectors, are same in box product. No need to prove that big way, I think. This is very straightforward, but otherwise, yeah, you can prove it by different ways, but unwantedly, you are just showing the lengthy calculations there. It will always come zero, whatever the vector f bar there, because it is a straightforward. F bar is a vector, curl f is also vector, del cross is there, so curl f is there. So A dot B cross C, and that is a box product, so that's a zero. So that is enough to write in the exam, even though it come. Okay, but you should write this detailed explanation. These lines are important, and then you can say, hence it is a zero there.